Okay, so my cake's nice and set now. It's been in the fridge for about an hour. So I'm just gonna be marzipanning the cake. So I need some apricot jam because we're gonna need to make sure that sticks onto the surface. Make sure it has been boiled, especially if you're doing something like a fruit cake that's gonna be stored for a long time, because you need to make sure there's no bacteria and it's gonna last. So just take a tiny bit of icing sugar and just work the marzipan. You need it to be sort of warm and pliable before you roll it out. So just start by rolling from the centre. What you're looking for is a nice even thickness. Now, because I'm a professional, I've been doing it for ages, I'm gonna get the right thickness. But there's these little guide sticks that you can buy here, and that will enable you to kind of roll out to one even thickness. Just gonna roll that onto the rolling pin. So I can now line it up in the middle, and then I'm gonna roll away over the cake. There we go. I'm now gonna take these smoothers. Now these are pretty essential really for cake decorating, because it prevents you from having any finger marks, which looks really unprofessional, and we're trying to go for the best finish here. So we've got a top smoother, and then we have two side smoothers which have the straight edge. Just give that a nice pressure on there, and that's done. If you do see any air bubbles, you can use one of these pin tools. If you haven't got a pin tool, you can just use a clean pin. And now I'm gonna go around the edges, and I'm being careful not to pull down. I'm not dragging it down, because it's gonna tear. So I'm just literally pressing it into the sides of the cake. And also, being careful not to have any creases here. You need to work fairly quickly with this as well, because it will dry out. So just try and, obviously you don't wanna rush it, but just be aware. So now I'm gonna cut away the excess of the marzipan. I'm gonna leave about 2 centimetres all the way round. Okay, now I'm gonna use my side smoothers again just to pull down the sides of the marzipan. And you can see it's coming below the cake drum. And then you just need to take a sharp knife and be careful here, it can be a bit tricky. Just go all the way around. So now we're ready to start smoothing the cake. So I'm gonna use my turntable. Again, take my top smoother, go over there, and just with the palm of my hand, just gently smoothing round with the marzipan, just to kind of get rid of any lumps and bumps. So now I'm gonna take my two side smoothers, and I'm gonna use one to stop the cake from moving, and the other one just to kind of smooth round. So again, I'm coming down to eye level. You really can't do this without the smoothers, because if you're trying to use your hands, you're just gonna get indentations of your fingers. Okay, so that's all ready. So we're gonna go on to the sugar paste stage now. We need to use something that's going to stick the sugar paste to the marzipan. Usually we'd use something like vodka or brandy, which tastes really nice. If you don't want to use any alcohol, you can use cold boiled water. Just make sure it's nice and damp all over, making sure you get right to the bottom. So I'm just gonna use some normal white sugar paste. You can pick this up at most supermarkets now. So just give it a knead. Rolling again from the middle outwards, away from myself and towards myself to stop getting any of those spidery bits. Quarter turn, again, make sure plenty of icing sugar under there, because that will stick very easily. Now with this one, you really need to work quickly. It's gonna dry out a lot faster than the marzipan. And roll that on there. I'm gonna line it up in the middle, make sure I've got enough on this side. And then rolling away. When I roll away, it's really going to be preventing any air bubbles being trapped. I've got the ridge there from the rolling pin, so I'm just going to polish that away with my top smoother. And again, just using the smoothers, just bringing the sugar paste down to below the level of the baseboard. There we go. So that's just ready to trim off. Again, I'm doing it the same way, holding it at a 90 degree angle, going all the way around. And then taking the side smoothers and smoothing off around the sides in exactly the same way. I've spotted an air bubble here, so I'm going to just pop that using my fingers just to smooth that out. If you don't get rid of the air bubble now, you're going to be sorry, because the next day you'll come down and there'll be a huge balloon coming out the side of your cake. Okay, yep, so I'm pretty happy with that. We're done. Ta-da!